Greetings from the Iowa Beef Center, and welcome to another edition of Cow Tip Tuesday. I'm Patrick Wall, Area Beef Field Specialist for ISU Extension and Outreach. This week's edition will give you some simple yet helpful tips at ensuring your winter feeding strategy goes as planned. The first tip is to involve a hay probe like this to get a forage analysis on every cutting and different kind of hay that you've either purchased or raised in the last year. The next steps will involve tips in labeling that hay to ensure it's fed properly at the right time of year to the right kind of animal. This tip simply involves a bright colored can of spray paint used to match to your forage analysis on what cutting and type of hay you're testing. This first example involves grass from first cutting, as well as a mixed alfalfa grass hay from first cutting as well. You'll notice a bale missing here on the right. We've started to feed some of that already. You may want to use a post and an old field sign or something more permanent for when the first bale leaves the row. When labeling in siled forages, you might also want to include the date the hay was wrapped to ensure proper ensilement before the hay gets fed. This particular sample is second cutting alfalfa haylage, so we can match that to our forage sample. I've also went through this line of hay and marked off every 10 bales. As the winter progresses, it might help you with your feed budget to see how you're doing versus how you budgeted. For any hay that you may have stored inside, it might be important to put that on the label as well. This is obviously third cutting alfalfa that we've stored in here. The forage analysis might not come back any different, but you may want to adjust your diets based on the amount of waste you can assume from hay that's stored inside. We also have one bale of 2020 crop hay sitting in here, so we labeled that as well to make sure we know that this is old crop hay and not from this year. It's also important to label any summer annuals that you might have in your forage program. These two examples here are an oats clover mix that was harvested for hay twice this summer. The sample on the right is obviously first cutting. Sample on the left is from the second cutting. These two samples side by side look very similar, but the forage analysis was quite different. These plants were taken at much different levels of maturity with both the clover and the oats. This example is simply labeled M3, which stands for mixed third cutting alfalfa grass. A forage analysis might reveal that this is your best product for maybe weaned calves or developing heifers and not the gestating cow herd. The reason this is important is it may be placed right next to a sample of hay that looks very similar but might test in a forage analysis to be quite different. Regardless of the size of the operation, it's amazing how many different classes and kinds of forages we can accumulate in a given growing season. Just like in precision farming, where farmers try to use the right soil type for the right crop and the right amount of fertilizer, beef producers can do the same thing by getting the right kind of hay to the right class of cattle at the right time of gestation or growth.